السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we'll take you back to the 1973 10th Ramadan war or 6th of October war. And at that time I was in the third year of my medical college and everything was stopped at a standstill. During Ramadan, the last 2 weeks of Ramadan will witness every Egyptian house is baking their cakes for Ramadan, for Eid, sorry, not for Ramadan. And I'll mention the name of the cakes in Arabic for the people who might listen to my English in Arabic, so they might find some of their friends to explain this to them. It's Ka'k, Urayiba, Oras, Minin, Shakalama, Baskawit, and others. And all the women in Egypt, no matter what, they become very well geared towards sitting for a week or two to start to prepare this. And you can see that the big tray going from the houses on the heads of the young children or the girls to the bakery to bake them for them. And you can smell the beautiful smell of baking powder, as well as the baked cakes and biscuits and others and the cookies in this time. At this year especially, no woman, no household was able to bake any cake of this or to show any celebration for Ramadan, because there's no household in Egypt which was not sending one of his sons or grandsons or cousins or nephews to the battlefield. All the Egyptian houses were sending their young ones to defend the country and to defend the bigger cause and to liberate the Sinai desert at that time. And if they found a family sending this or baking this in the house or sending something to the bakery, this family will be cursed by the rest of the community in the area as well. During that time, as I said, I was in the third year in the medical school. I went to approach one of the school for girls. Which talk about girls at the age of 14 or 13 to 16 to teach them first aid subject. And I was approved by the head teacher, and I was filling all the classes which was not attended by the teacher because the teacher is absent or sick or whatever it is. And I was going from a class to a class and level to a level. After they checked on my credibility and my integrity and my behavior with those young girls. Not only that, I have written a drama, a play or for the theater about in a poetic way. And even I was trying to lead the girls and to stand up and to actually, I was acting as a writer, as an author, as well as a director for this play. This was the culture. The culture of the Egyptian was united behind the army who was trying to liberate the Sinai and to defend their children who are fighting for the liberation of Sinai. At this war, I have four of my family members who are part of the military in the battlefield. One of them was an officer in the second army in the artillery side. The second was actually a conscript or a soldier actually in the same army as well. The third one was from my, these are from my father's side. The third one also from my father's side was an engineer as a officer as well in the army, but in a different area. And number four was another mechanical engineer, or sorry, electrical engineer in the army from my mother's side. So four young men were standing to defend the country at the time. So no, and every household in Egypt at the time was standing up for this. So nobody could actually celebrate or feel the joy of the celebration of Ramadan or Eid because of the young ones were there. This was the spirit, to be united about around the greater cause, not a small cause, not actually a family cause, not actually a tribal cause, but this is a greater cause for the whole country as well. So this kind of unity has to be brought back to the nation when they look at the bigger picture of the surrounding, when they find corruption, they found injustice, they found displacement, they found oppression, they found no freedom and dictatorship and others. Because nobody can do it alone. It has to be a united, unifying effort to defend the country, the nation, and the humanity. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.